Hey, I'm Kevin Wallace. I am the Director of Forecasting at Surfline. And new in February, we've got a Swell Spectra data graph that gives you deeper insight into the swell forecast. The spectrograph is a visual representation of the different swells that might be happening at a particular point in time. And we have a couple different ways to look at it. So if you're paying attention, we brought buoy swell spectra out last month, and that is actually measuring the swells that are occurring right now. It's an actual observation measured by a buoy. And today we're looking at the swell spectrograph, which is produced by our Lotus swell model. And it's a projection out in time of what you can expect the surf to look like and conditions to look like at one of your local spots. So to find the swell spectrograph, you can go to any report page, make sure you're looking at the swell graph versus the swell table, and then scroll down almost to the bottom of the page, and just above weather, you'll see that swell spectrograph. On iOS, you can click the advanced swell button below the surf graph on any spot page. I really like the swell spectra because it helps me determine where I might go surfing and gives me deeper information on making those decisions. So similar surf height numbers for a bunch of different spots, they all say 3 to 4 feet or 4 to 6 feet or whatever it happens to be. Without digging a little bit deeper, I may not know that, hey, beach breaks are gonna be way better on this 4 to 6 foot day than the points or reefs or vice versa. And that's where the swell spectra comes in. You know, you can go in and look, and if you see very concentrated energy in, say, medium or mid or even long periods, my first instinct is to be, I'm going to a point, a reef, a spot that's got structure or something like that, that's gonna be able to take that very concentrated long period energy and turn it into peaky surf or lined up peak, something like that. On the opposite end of the spectrum, so to speak, is a mixture or a wide distribution of swell periods and potentially swell directions. And if I see something like that, then I know the spot that I actually like to surf the most in my neck of the woods is probably gonna be pretty good. There's a good chance that that beach break is gonna be peaky and it's gonna offer some great shoulders and corners to pick off. So to get that extra layer deeper beyond just a 4 to 6 foot and fair or fair to good or whatever it happens to be, to get that extra little bit of information can make all the difference in the world to me.